In the previous video, I have given you introduction of this chapter, and now I am continuing the same topic, angles made by transversal. Last time I explained you interior angles, exterior angles, pair of corresponding angles, pair of alternate interior angles, alternate exterior angles, pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal. Today I am telling you, see, if suppose two lines are given to you, L and M, and T is the transversal given to you. Now these two angles are said interior angles on the same side of transversal. See, this is the transversal and they both are on the same side, and both are inside, both lie between the lines, so we can say them interior angles because both are interior and both are on the same side of transversal. So this is the pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal, and one more pair can be possible, that is here. See the diagram. L is the, L and M are two lines, T is transversal. So these two angles are also interior angles on the same side of transversal. We can say them co-interior angles. Co-interior. Co means these two are partner, means, and interior means on the same side. Transversal of, come to the next topic, transversal of parallel lines. Now do you remember what are parallel lines? They are the lines on a plane that do not meet anywhere. These lines, if we extend on both sides, they never meet. This you have studied earlier in class 6 and 7. Now see the examples from your daily life. See, suppose this this is the blackboard. See, this edge and this edge, both the edges never meet. So this is the example of parallel line. See, this edge and this edge, these both edges are parallel because they do not meet at any point. Any other example we can take, like edges of your book, maths book, copy, your register, edges of scale. So many examples are there in the daily routine for the parallel lines. Now you have to note down three important facts about the parallel line, and the, if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, suppose these are two parallel lines and these are cut by a transversal T, lines are L and M, then each pair of corresponding angles are, what are the corresponding angles? This angle and this angle, these two are corresponding angles. If lines are parallel, then corresponding angles are equal. This is the fact you have to note down. If two parallel lines are cut by transversal, then always corresponding angles are equal in measure. This is the first point. And the second point is, if two parallel lines are parallel given to you and cut by a transversal, then each pair of alternate interior angle is always equal, means these two are alternate interior angles. Now these two angles will be equal. And any other pair is possible? Yes, this pair and this pair, this is also alternate interior angles. So this angle and this angle, these both angles are always equal in measure. Now come to third fact about these. Third fact is about the co-interior angles. If two lines are given to you, parallel lines, and T is the transversal, the third fact is sum of co-interior angle is always supplementary, or you can say interior angles on the same side of transversal is always supplementary. Whatever the angle is given here, एंड एंगल इज गिवन हियर. इफ यू विल डू द सम इट विल बी ऑलवेज 180 डिग्री इफ द लाइन्स आर पैरेलल. सेम वे दिस साइड ऑल्सो वी कैन सी दैट सम ऑफ दीज टू एंगल्स विल बी ऑलवेज सप्लीमेंट्री. सो सम ऑफ टू को इंटीरियर एंगल्स इज सप्लीमेंट्री when the two lines are given to you parallel. So write down these three points that if two lines are cut by a transversal, two parallel lines are cut by transversal, corresponding angles are always equal. These are also corresponding. This and this always equal. This and this always equal. Same way alternate, second point is alternate interior angles will be always equal. And third point, lines are parallel, then sum of co-interior is supplementary. So learn these three points. You can easily remember these results if you can look for relevant shapes. Like these two are parallel lines. This is the transversal. These two are corresponding angles. Now these will show F shape. F shape always stand for corresponding angles. See here. How you will make F? When the corresponding angles are given, F shape will always represent that these are corresponding angles. Now see, these are corresponding angles. So how they are representing F shape? This is alphabet F. And F shape stands for corresponding angles. Same way for alternate interior angles, Z shape. These two are parallel lines. This is transversal. These two angles are alternate interior angles. How they are showing Z shape? Like this. They are always between Z shape. Now see, these two are again alternate interior angles and they will do like Z shape. This is Z shape. So this is easy for you to remember these results. Now the next topic is checking for parallel lines. हमें check करना है कि lines are parallel or not. For this you have to note down when a transversal cut two lines. Suppose these are two lines and a transversal is cutting. Then if pair of corresponding angles are equal, आपको check करना है कि what is the measurement of corresponding angle given here. Suppose it is given to you 75, but this is given to you 78 or 80, then the lines are not parallel because corresponding angles are not given here equal. But what you will check here, if corresponding angles are given to you equal, then you can say that lines are parallel. It will be asked from you that lines are parallel or not. Line L is parallel to or M or not. Then here we will say L is not parallel to M because corresponding angles are not equal. And second thing what we can check, if pair of alternate interior angles are equal, like two lines are given to you, this is the transversal, and if alternate interior are given to you equal, this and this angles are given to you equal, this means lines are parallel. This is the condition to check that lines are parallel or not. And third thing, how do we check? Pair of co-interior angles must be supplementary. Suppose in any question, this and this angles are given to you. These measurement of this and this angle is given to you. You have to do the sum of these two angles. If the sum is 180 supplementary, it means these two lines are parallel. So these three conditions we have to check for the parallel lines. Now see, page 110, this trig is given to you and it is asked here, this figure is given to you and the question is line L parallel to M, and we have to give the reason why. Now see here, alternate interior angles are equal, so lines are parallel. So we write here, answer of this is yes, L is parallel to M. And what is the reason? Because alternate interior angles are, here you will write alternate interior angles are equal. Same way, second part is given to you. You see here, how do we do the second part? In the second part, figure is given to you in this way. Here this angle is given to you 50 and this angle is given to you 130. This is interior but this is exterior. So I can do, what I will do here, I will make angle 1 itself. Now angle 1 and 130 are vertically opposite angle. These two angles are vertically opposite. I will write angle 1 equal to 130. Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles are always equal. So this angle will be 130. Now see, these two angles are co-interior angles. And what must be the sum of co-interior angles? Ye rule tha ki co-interior angles ka sum agar supplementary hai, then lines are parallel. To hum kar denge sum of co-interior angles. Now do the sum, angle 1 plus 50 degree, angle 1 kya hai, 130 degree plus 50, it means 180, it means ye supplementary hai, so sum of co-interior angles is supplementary, it means lines are parallel. We can do the same sum by another methods also, like these two are linear pair. Suppose if I will find out this angle, I am giving the name here angle 1. You have to write down angle 1 using pencil. Now this angle 1 is, now these two angles will make linear pair. They both are on the same line. So these two are adjacent and linear pair. Angle 1 plus 130, they are on the same line, straight line. So it is 180. So angle 1 will be here, 180 minus 130 means angle 1 50 degree. Now see, if this is 50 and this is also 50, they both are corresponding angles. Now corresponding angles are equal, so lines are parallel. You write here angle 1 and angle 50, means this is, suppose this is angle 2. Angle 1 equal to angle 2 and write down here corresponding angles. Write the reason always, otherwise your sum will be wrong. Now angle 1 and 2 are equal, corresponding angles are equal, so lines are parallel. We can give third way also, we can give the third way. How? The third way of doing this sum, same sum. We will find out angle 1 here by linear pair. Now again 1 and 130 will make 180 linear pair and angle 1 will be 50 degree. Now in this condition, alternate interior angles are equal. Now alternate interior angles, if alternate interior angles are equal, lines will be parallel. So the same sum we can do by three methods. You can choose any method which you feel suitable. Now third, try this on the same page. This figure is given to you and question is L parallel to M and what is? No, here the question is L is given to you parallel and now the question is you have to find the value of X. Lines are already given to you parallel. Now L is parallel to you, to M, and T is transversal. Ye to pehle se hi diya hua hai. Now, sum of co-interior angles is 180. Jab lines parallel ho, lines are parallel, then sum of co-interior is always 180. That's why I am doing the sum equal to 180. Now x will be 180 minus 70 means 110. This we have to find out. Now come to exercise 5.2. Question number 1. State the property used in each of the following statement. Now the statement is given to you. If A is parallel to B, then angle 1 equal to angle 5. This is angle 1 and this is angle 5. This A line is parallel to B is given. These two lines are parallel. This is transversal. Then angle 1 and 5 are equal. Which property we have to tell? So these two angles are corresponding angle. So the property you have to write here. Corresponding angle property. Corresponding angle property. Now the second part is, if angle 4 is equal to angle 6, then A is parallel to B. It means this angle and this angles are equal. Alternate interior angles are equal. So lines are parallel. So what is the property name? Name of the property is alternate interior angles property. This statement is by which property, using which property, then name of the property we have to give here. And in the third part, the statement is given to you. Angle 4 and 5, sum of angle 4 and 5 is 180, then A is parallel to B. It means, which is the angle 4th and 5th? It means co-interior, sum of co-interior is 180, that's why lines are parallel. Which property is this? This is co-interior angles property. Or you can write here, sum of interior angles on the same side of transversal. This property is also called sum of interior angles on the same side of transversal. This also we can write. This is all about today's work, and rest of the exercise we will do in the next video.